Neanderthals have been one of the greatest mysteries throughout history. These enigmatic beings are remarkable not only for the size of their brains, but also for their incredible endurance and ability to evolve. Neanderthals, whose traces are found even in Anatolia, have managed to survive even in the most challenging conditions. So, who are these Neanderthals? What did they feel when they first met our ancestors? And perhaps most importantly, why did they suddenly disappear? We can define Neanderthals as close relatives of modern humans. They are a human species that lived with us in Europe and Asia for thousands of years. Yes, they are a human species, and they are the most similar to us of all living things. Their physique was so robust and their musculature so strong that even today's bodybuilding champions would look ordinary next to them. However, the latest findings about them date back 30,000 years. According to scientists, Neanderthals became extinct 30,000 years ago. But why do we still think they were cavemen? This misconception was created by Hollywood. But we now know that this is not true. In particular, remains found in the Shanidar cave in northern Iraq show that Neanderthals buried their dead and even decorated the graves with flowers. They also made hunting tools and glued their distant heads together using adhesives of their own invention. They domesticated fire. The reason why their physical structure is so different and strong from ours is that Neanderthals were the first human species to evolve in Europe. At that time, 500,000 years ago, there was a great ice age in Europe, and it was not everyone's ability to survive in these conditions. Their physical structure was shaped by these climatic conditions. Homo sapiens first encountered Neanderthals when they migrated to Europe. They may have felt confusion and fear, but instead of violence, the encounter resulted in mutual interaction. Two different species of humans, cousins in fact, chose to live together rather than turn against each other in order to survive and thrive. They even mated. Today, between 2% and 4% of our genetic makeup is made up of Neanderthal remains. This is the result of frequent mating between Neanderthals and modern humans, which ranged from Europe to Central Asia. Only people living in Africa do not have Neanderthal genetic remains, because Neanderthals never traveled to Africa. We know that Neanderthals had a sense of art, even a primitive one. Their handprints, still preserved in some caves in Europe, and some musical instruments found with their remains, such as flutes made of stone and bone, show that they were among humanity's earliest musicians. Vanished 30,000 years ago, traces of these cousins are still here. Perhaps they left these traces so that one day it would be known that they had lived here. But did they develop a spoken language of their own? We don't know that for sure. Yes, they live in groups, they hunt in groups, and they have some knowledge of customs and traditions passed down from ancestor to child. But we have no idea whether they had a spoken language. As for why they became extinct, there are various theories about the extinction of this human species, which is thought to have become extinct 30,000 years ago. The first theory is that Neanderthals were not as practical as us and adapted to new climatic conditions and lifestyles. According to the remains found, it seems that instead of staying in one place and living a systematic life, they were much more mobile and inefficient. For example, the stoves they used for cooking meat were usually used once and then abandoned after garbage and debris were left on them. It is even known that they had to resort to cannibalism. It is also thought to have played a role. It is estimated that Neanderthals did not reproduce as efficiently as we do. This was true even though they cared for the sick, fell in love, kept a summer, and used tools. Perhaps even making the first flutes in history, they were far behind us in terms of practicality. While modern humans, Homo sapiens, caught prey by throwing spears in the same period, the thick and short arms of Neanderthals did not allow this. They had to hide the prey they netted. For this reason, they had to get very close to their large prey, which is why almost all Neanderthal bones have severe injuries, severe fractures, and fatal damage. Another theory is that they were killed by modern humans. Of course, there would have been conflicts, but there is not much evidence of that. Indeed, we should not forget that very few people lived in a very large world at that time. Another theory holds different mysteries. According to this theory, Neanderthals didn't actually disappear. They are somehow trying to survive, but can this really happen? Thought to have gone extinct 30,000 years ago, could the last representatives of this human species be trying to survive by escaping from us? Recently, some hunters in areas of Mongolia far from civilization claim to have encountered an interesting species. The descriptions, coincidentally, seem to be very consistent with Neanderthal man. Moreover, it was also a geographical month well suited to these parts of Mongolia that had evolved for a cold climate. Some researchers from Europe examined the areas described but found no traces of Neanderthals and the claim was shelved. But this does not mean that they will not be found in the future. One of the best-known Neanderthal stories is about a woman named Zana, who lived in the Caucasus in the 1800s. Zana was a woman in the mountains who was described as very large, hairy, and smarter than us. Hunters captured her and put her in a cage, and she even had children born to villagers who had intercourse with her. Many black and white photographs of these children have survived. Their appearance is very similar to Neanderthals, but DNA tests on the bones suggest that they were Homo sapiens, modern humans, and that they looked like that have researchers excited by the prospect that it could be Neanderthals. So far, no such evidence has been found, but the fact that traces of these cousins, the closest evolution has developed to us, can be found to this day, suggests that the only way for them to survive must have been to stay away from us. If Neanderthals were among us today, what might they look like? A study has been done on this. For example, if they lived today and wore a suit, they would look like what you see on your screen right now. Or if they wanted to take a cover photo for a magazine, they would probably smile like this. With these images, we can better understand that the similarity between us is more than we thought. Today, many Neanderthal remains are thought to exist. For example, excavations in Turkey's Karain Cave have unearthed axes belonging to Neanderthals. There may be more remains in the cave, but because it is so ancient, work has to proceed slowly and carefully. Every inch of sand is being scrutinized. It is very difficult to reach this conclusion. Also, many traces of Neanderthals were found in the excavations started in 2017 due to fossils found by chance in the Banas district of Usak, Turkey. Approximately 100,000 stone fragments will be analyzed one by one. It is thought that there were hot water sources here at that time, and Neanderthals stayed in the open to understand. The fact that it belongs to a more recent period than Karain Cave, and that it is spread over a large area, makes people really curious. Let's see what else we will encounter next. Subscribe to our channel for more such videos.